We will now resume, and I would be grateful if members could ensure that they are in the chamber for items of business in which they are involved. The next item of business is consideration of Parliamentary Bureau motion. Point of order, Siobhan Brown.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. As time is really of the essence, as the energy prices are going up tomorrow and people are trying to submit their energy prices to their company, all the energy companies' websites have crashed today and are currently down. And can I ask if the Scottish Government can intervene to ask them to extend the process for a few days?
That is not a point of order, Ms Brown. The next item of business is consideration of Parliamentary Bureau Motion 3904 on approval of an SSI, and I ask George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau to move the motion.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and moved.
Thank you, Minister. I call on Alex Cole-Hamilton.
Thank you very much, Presiding Officer. Members will recall that Willie Rennie spoke on last week's Social Security SSI, so I won't repeat all of the arguments and analysis that he made at that time. However, I can confirm that the Scottish Liberal Democrats can't support this twin SSI for the same reason, in that it only increases disability benefits by 3.1%. That's well behind the 6% being applied to other benefits. Indeed, the OBR now warns inflation could peak at 9% at the end of this year. And if the Scottish Government had got its act together in devolving these benefits, disabled people could have got more help with the cost of living crisis. Instead, they remain on the old system. 7 years after all parties in this chamber agreed that powers should be devolved. That was the SNP Government's choice and timetable, and the result is disabled people being left out in the cold. For that reason, Scottish Liberal Democrats can't vote for this SSI this evening.
Thank you. I call on Ben McPherson.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. First of all, my sincere apologies for the delay. As I set out to Mr Rennie recently, with regard to the disability payments that the Scottish Government is delivering, but also delivering through agency agreement with the DWP. The reason that we are uprating those benefits, so child disability payment and adult disability payment, by 3.1% based on the September CPI, is because while we both launch our benefits, so adult disability payment is our 12th benefit, while we are doing that, but also undertaking case transfer into our system, it's extremely important that we don't create a two-tier system and that those who are Scottish recipients of working age disability living allowance, child disability living allowance and personal independence payment receive the same rate of payment as those on the Scottish benefits of child disability payment and adult disability payment. Until the transfer process is complete, we can't diverge from DWP's approach. I think that it's unfortunate that the hyperbole used by Mr Cole-Hamilton and Mr Rennie previously. Of course, the Parliament undertook the process of the Social Security Act 2018. Since then, we've created a new agency that is performing well. We have delivered 12 benefits, 7 of which are only available in Scotland and not in the rest of the UK. It's been a remarkable process of significant achievement and delivery through a pandemic where both governments, not just the Scottish Government, also the UK Government, had to consider priorities and resources. And of course, in that period, we delivered the Scottish Child Payment, which is a benefit that's not available in the rest of the UK and I know is supported across the chamber. So, you know, we all want social security in Scotland to work. It's important that we deal in accuracy and clarity and context. And I would think it would be better for the Liberal Democrats to participate positively and constructively in a shared agenda of the delivery of social security in Scotland. Mr Cole-Hamilton has never requested a meeting with me on social security. He'd be welcome to one if he would like it. And I can appraise him more on the reality of the situation and the achievements of the Scottish Government. And I urge members to support the SSI. Thank you.
Thank you. The question on this motion will be put at decision time. The next item of business is consideration of four Parliamentary Bureau motions, and I ask George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau to move motions 3862 and 3903 on committee membership, 3863 on substitution on committees, and 3905 on suspension and variation of standing orders.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and all moved.
Thank you, Minister. The question on these motions will be put at decision time, and there are three questions to be put as a result of today's business. The first is that motion 3864, in the name of Keith Brown, on Minor Strike Pardons Scotland Bill be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed. The next question is that motion 3904, in the name of George Adam, on approval of an SSI, be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we'll move to a vote, and there'll be a short suspension to allow members to access the digital voting system.